In this video, we will simulate the near-field emissions of this KiCad layout. We will perform this simulation with the completely free tools KiCad and openEMS. With free, I mean completely free, even for commercial use. This is part 2 of a video series on how to improve emissions on a two-layer PCB. In the last video, we looked at the cross-section of the magnetic and electric fields around this board. And this time we will try to improve the layout further by analyzing the three-dimensional fields. If you're new to this channel, it makes sense to also watch the previous video. The link is in the description. As a summary, in the last video we added some vias for the high-frequency return currents and also found out that the crosstalk is greatly reduced by simply changing the PCB thickness. Alright, so how to further improve the emissions? Well, the best thing that you can do layout-wise is to via-stitch the whole trace. This here is the near-field emission result after doing this. So this makes a huge difference, but the injection point still radiates quite a bit more than the rest of the trace. This is because we did not apply our via-stitching technique also to the connector. Let's change this and look at the updated simulation result. We can visualize this even better by changing to the side view. The difference might not be too obvious, but there is definitely an improvement. Let's also compare the new results with the initial layout. So now we managed to improve our near-field emissions, but in an EMC lab you will measure the emissions of the board in a few meters distance. So you are mostly interested in the fields far away from a PCB, which are called far-field emissions. They look like this. Sadly, this is all we can do layout-wise. Even if you would change to a simple multi-layer PCB, you would have a hard time to much further reduce the emissions. You can, for example, get rid of the bottom layer emissions by using microvias, as shown here. But once you place components on both sides, this effect gets useless and only helps to make the PCB layout more dense, but not really helps with emissions besides having the copper layers quite close to each other. The only thing you can do without changing or adding components is to add a shield around the PCB, as shown here. So after we added a shield can, we have zero emissions. But sadly, once we add a cable, we again can measure some emissions. The simplest thing you can do here is to put the cables close together. But this isn't perfect and some emissions will remain. A twisted cable won't help either, as it also radiates. The only way to completely remove emissions is by using a shielded trace, for example a coaxial cable. But even here, at some point, the outer ground shield will have to be opened up. For example, this would be the case if you want to connect the board to any kind of power supply or a battery or a leasing. To keep the emissions inside the shield, you will have to use some filtering components, which we will cover in another video. Alright, let's start with the simulation process for the near-field emissions. I will first show you the process for KiCad 6, and after that I will also show you the process for KiCad 8. First download the KiCad layout from the link in the description. Check if you can open it with KiCad 6. If this worked, open FreeCAD. Change to the part workbench. Then create a new project. Open the FreeCAD to openEMS macro. If you don't know this macro yet, check out the video link in the description that shows you how to install openEMS. Close the macro and reopen it. Now import the KiCad layout file. Wait until the report view shows an all done message. After that, close the macro window. And expand this object. Mark the two items inside. And make a union out of them. This step now created fully copper-filled vias. Mark these two objects and create a simple copy of them. Now keep the two simple objects and delete the rest. Rename the object that includes the copper traces to copper and rename the PCB to FR4. Create the cube and call it air. The air object must cover the PCB and should be 10 mm bigger than the PCB in all directions. You can make the components transparent in the View tab. Now copy the air object and call the new object age field. Resize and replace it so that it is 1 mm smaller than the air box in all directions. Copy the air box again and call the new object port in. Place it in between the VCC input and ground. Start the FreeCAD to openEMS marker again. Once open, go to the Grids tab and create the grid. In the Material Settings tab, add Air and FR4. In the Excitation Settings tab, add a Step Excitation. In the Port Settings tab, add the Input Port. And don't forget to change the direction to X. Skip the Lumped Parts tab. And in the Probe Settings tab, let's add a H-Field probe. In the Simulation Params tab, I will choose 500 time steps and set the simulation boundary to Moore. In the Processing tab, you can enable the creation of a peck dump. Now go back to the Object Assignment tab and assign all the components. Save the settings file and generate the MATLAB code. Open the MATLAB code with Octave. And click on Run. Confirm the message in the command window with yes. Now close the preview window. Once the first time steps were simulated, you can preview them in Paraview. Do this by going to the simulation output folder. Then type in Paraview here and hit enter. Open the field dump. We now have to convert the data to be able to view it in Paraview. Do this by choosing the filter resample to image. Change the color representation from solid to H field and change from the outline view to the volume view. Now go to the last time step to see some data. You can change the color range here. And you can change the color map here. Alright, this was the simulation process with KiCad 6. Now let's repeat the same simulation with KiCad 8. For this, please download the KiCad 8 layout from the link in the description. Open it with KiCad 8. In KiCad 8, you can export the step file directly. First, export the board data. And then the copper data. Start FreeCAD. Create a new project. Change to the part workbench and import it to step files. Mark both objects and create a simple copy of them. And delete the two initial objects. The remaining process steps are the same as with KiCad 6. The only difference is that now the vias have the original shape with just 25 micrometers outer ring. This sadly requires a 10 times finer mesh than with the fully copper filled vias. For this specific PCB, I needed just 4 GB of RAM for the fully copper filled simulation, but 64 GB of RAM to simulate the original shape. So I think most of you will have an easier time to work with the KiCad 6 approach. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.